Today we are going to discuss about hydropower. So hydropower, it uses the flow of water which is flowing towards the sea to generate electricity. So it is in the visible form, and by using large dams we are creating reservoirs, and by the difference in water levels such as upstream and downstream of the dam allows the use of potential energy in water. By that we are going to generate electricity. So there is a range in size, that is few tens of megawatts to the several hundreds of megawatts. So how it works? So we are having reservoir behind the dam, that is lake. This water pushes or comes with a high pressure to the dam. So the turbine passage, when it is open, so the water will flow and hit the blades of a turbine, which is in turn called as propellers. So this starts rotating, which is in turn connected to a generator. From that we are going to generate electricity. So hydropower, so its capacity is few tens of megawatts to several hundreds of megawatts. Then the biggest power station, that is in China, so its total capacity is 22,500 megawatt. So other very large installations are in Itaipu plant at the border of Brazil and Paraguay. So La Grande plant in Canada having capacity of 15,000 megawatt. Then some countries rely to a large extent on hydropower for their electricity production, such as Brazil. So its energy consumption from hydro, that is 83%, Argentina 25%, Canada 60%, Chile 50%, Norway 99%, Sweden 50%, right? So although the amount of electricity produced from hydro, it steadily goes on increasing. Let us take an example. In 1973, so electricity generation, that was 1400 terawatt hour electricity was produced. Similarly, in 2007, it raised to 3100 terawatt hour and 15.6%. So the current trend in hydropower is towards very large installation, that is in Asia, Africa, South Africa, South America, right? So they are planning to have 40,000 megawatt installation, and it is called as Grand Inga. It is Democratic Republic of Congo, with electricity being transported by HVDC link over whole of Africa. Small hydro may be easier to build, but there at the moment no indications of any growth in the area. So this could be not only due to the lack of proper incentive schemes, but also due to the lack of potential. So advantages: once the dam is constructed, the electricity can be produced at a constant rate. Then when there is no need of electricity, at that time the sluice gate can be closed, and we can stop the electricity generation. Then dams are designed to last many decades. Then that means the electricity generation by the dams, that will be for long time. life span will be more. Then the lake that formed behind the dam can be used for water sports, then any pleasure activities, right? So it will attract usually tourist people, it will attract, right? So the lake's water can be used for irrigation purpose also. So as there are advantages, there are some disadvantages also. So to build, the cost required is very high. Then high cost of dam construction means it must operate for many decades to become profitable. Then flooding of large area of land, right? It is natural environment is destroyed. Then people, the people living in village and town that are in the valley to be flooded must move out, right? So in some countries, people forcibly removed so that the hydropower schemes can go ahead. Then building large dams can seriously geological damage. For example, the building of Hoover Dam in USA triggered a number of earthquakes and has depressed the earth's surface at its location. So these are some of the disadvantages. So environmental impact. The EHA, that is International Hydropower Association Working Group on Environmental Impact Assessment, EIA, calls for impact assessment to be an integral part of multidisciplinary planning approach and to include a strong element of public consultation. So this EIA, it should cover both positive and negative impact, both upstream and downstream of a proposed project. Thank you.